Hello everyone, my name is Martin Bialas, I'm a member of Atavism team, and today I will show you how to adjust your Unity 2019.2 and .3 to work well with the newest Atavism 2019.1. So let's start. So first thing which we want to do is we want to switch our .NET 4X to 3.5. So in order to do that, we have to open Edit Project Settings, and in the player settings we want to switch API from .NET 4.x to 3.5. This is optional step actually, but Unity at this point has some issues where Unity has around 30% to freeze after you will try to enter the runtime. So it's recommended to switch to 3.5 at this point. So let's switch and let's confirm it. And restart. So Unity recompiled all elements, and we are back in .NET 3.5 as we set it before. So the next thing which we want to do, as we are in the Players tab, we want to switch the color space to make it more beautiful and more accurate for your PC game. For most mobile games, we will want to keep it as a gamma, as some of the old mobile devices don't support linear color space. But I think it's a good step because most of you will develop your game on PC, of course. For optimization purpose, I will also check dynamic batching and graphics jobs experimental. So this is all settings which we want to set in the project settings. Let's close this window. The next thing which we want to set is some elements from the Unity Package Manager. So let's open window, package manager, and here, as you can see, we have Text Mesh Pro 1.3.0. So this is the proper version installed by default in Unity 2018.3, and we want to keep it that way. But what we want to do is we want to add post processing stack. So let's just hit install. Okay, and once we have installed post-processing, we want to close this window, and we will need to install something called Text Mesh Pro Essentials. So in order to do that, we will have to open Window, Text Mesh Pro, and here is the option which we want to use, import TMP essential resources. So let's click it, let's import it. And the last thing which we want to adjust is layers. So let's click here in layers, let's click edit layers, and then expand layers options. And we want to basically copy and paste this post-processing layer into something, some different layer, as layer 8 is used by default in Atavism and many models are in this layer, so we want to keep it that way. Of course you can adjust it, but it's recommended to, and the easiest way is to keep it that way. So let's call it target table, The next layer which we want to add is minimap. Naming convention for minimap is important. And the third layer which I want to add is a very optional layer, but I will add it anyway. Atavism texts. Let's call it Atavism texts. So basically, we are using this layer to separate mob names texts from rest of the layers, and basically we will set we are setting in our case we are setting on the main camera in the main wall scene that this main camera wouldn't render this layer, and this layer would be rendered by the another camera attached as a child. This will prevent from adding post-processing effects on top of our atavism text, so they would look more natural. So after these settings, we will just clear the logs, and we will import atavism Unity package. So once we have all imported, we can see that we have only some missing prefabs for our terrain, but these prefabs are on the terrain, so it's because the because of new Unity terrain options. So all went fine, and now we can configure our atavism. So by default, we can open atavism configuration window, and here we will just add our server credentials and server hostname. Atavism comes with default database credentials, like for remote connections, it's atavism and atavism user, and database password is also atavism. And we will tick this checkbox to propagate these settings to all of our other databases, and we can check and verify the connection, so it's fine. And this is all for atavism editor. One thing which is worth to mention, that these two buttons were automatically lighten up to blue. It's because my server is already started, so this A and W are only for our pre-made virtual machines, so they won't be lighten up to blue color, and they will become remain red for Atavism Manager and custom Linux installations. So you shouldn't worry about it. And last thing which we want to adjust is we want to open Dragon Sun scenes, and let's open login scene. Let's click on Atavism Core, and let's add this IP address which we propagate in our Atavism Editor option for the database connection for the host. So this is our Atavism Server IP, and in the build settings we will add this login scene, character selection scene, and mostly main world scene. You can also add arenas, of course, and single player and guild private instances. So that's all for this part. Our project is set up. There are no errors, and we set up all from the ground, so from the empty Unity project till a basic Atavism setup with import and some Atavism settings. So that's all for this part, for this tutorial. I hope you like it, and see you in the next one. Bye bye.